Bristol Community College, Mathematics with Dan Avedikian, Math 119, Fundamental Statistics, Section 9.2, Problem 5. This is Section 9.2, Problem Number 5. It says a random sample of 16 large cups of coffee from the BCC Hawk's Nest had a sample mean of 95 milligrams of caffeine with a sample standard deviation of 8 milligrams. Find a 99% confidence interval for the average amount of caffeine in all large coffees from the Hawk's Nest. So the formula we need to use for this problem is x bar plus or minus s over square root of n times t sub c. There are two confidence interval formulas for a population mean. The one I have on the board here is the one you use when you do not know the population standard deviation, which we don't. We know the sample standard deviation, which is a more realistic case. So let's fill in the formula. X bar is the sample mean, which the question tells us is 95 milligrams of caffeine. So 95 is the X bar, plus or minus S, the sample standard deviation, which the question also tells us is 8. Over square root of n, n is the size of the sample, so the size of our sample is 16. There are 16 cups of coffee in the sample. Don't forget the square root. And t sub c is the confidence coefficient. So to find this value of t sub c, you want to go to the student's t distribution, which is attached to the end of the homework assignment. Find the correct row and the correct column and see where they intersect. That will give you the value of your confidence coefficient, t sub c. So the column is determined by doing 1 minus the confidence interval as a decimal, because they give it to you in a percent all the time, but you have to write it as a decimal, which I'll abbreviate a little bit, over 2. So 1 minus the confidence interval as a decimal is 1 minus 0.99. This is a 99% confidence interval, so again, as a decimal, it's 0.99. Don't forget the 2 in the denominator. So 1 minus 0.99 is 0.01, and when you divide that by 2, you'd get 0.005. And again, that 0.005 is the column heading that you want to look under in your student's t-distribution chart. So now the row is determined by the size of the sample. The row you look in is one less than the size of the sample. It's labeled DF, or degrees of freedom. So if our sample size is 16, our degrees of freedom would be 15, one less than the sample size. So you will look in the 0.005 column, see where it intersects with the 15 degrees of freedom row, and you will find that those two intersect at a value of 2.947. So now that we have that, 2.947, that's what goes in for T sub C, our confidence coefficient. So now the formula is completely filled out. Now it's just a matter of doing the math. If you can fill in the formula correctly and you take your time, you need to use a calculator, you will most likely get the right answer. If you make a mistake, it will probably occur up to this point. So now that we have it filled in, first problem we have to deal with is the square root. Get rid of the square root first. This is an easy square root to take. So I have 95 plus or minus 8 over 4, because the square root of 16 is 4. 4 times 4 is 16. And I'll leave the rest of the numbers the way they are for now. So the next thing that I can do is reduce the 8 over 4. That reduces nicely to 2. So it becomes 95 plus or minus 2 times 2.947. Now I can go ahead and multiply the 2.947 times 2 and get one number after the plus and minus. It'd be 95 plus or minus. 2 times 2.947 is 5.894. So that 5.894 is what you'd call your margin of error. And once you have that one number value after your plus and minus, you can split the formula into a separate plus and a separate minus to find the low end and high end of your confidence interval. So the low end of the confidence interval will come from the x bar 95 minus the margin of error 5.894 2, the upper end of your confidence interval, will be the x bar of 95 plus the margin of error of 5.894. Same numbers, one has a minus in between, one has a plus. So on the low end, when I subtract 95 minus 5.894 will be 89.106. And then the upper end of my confidence interval come from 95 plus 5.894, which will be 100.894. So this tells me that based on only 16 cups of coffee that I sampled, I'm 99% sure that 89.106 to 100.894 is an interval where the true average of the amount of caffeine per large coffee can be found.